considered here is one of two alternatives, either a shorter period of time, as we discussed when we started, or perhaps a license with conditions. And the reason I think that that would be the appropriate remedy here is, Alistair had no benefit that reflects the real concern about the use of prohibited substances in terms of performance enhancement. I think we all agree, or we can agree, that, that's the focus of it, we understand the importance of it, and we understand that that's the intent, the statute's intent of the commission's responsibilities. I've read the commission's message to the public about what its purpose is. But there was no reason for Alistair to knowingly ingest this solution that contained testosterone for performance-enhancing purposes. And if there had been some clandestine purpose for his ingestion of this material, it would not have been documented in medical records that are easily retrievable. Alistair never asked anybody not to make records. Alistair never asked anybody to conceal anything. In fact, thanks to Alistair, we have Dr. Molina, because it's Alistair who identified the doctor, made him available for all of us to inquire of. The doctor voluntarily came to Nevada from another jurisdiction without a subpoena. He answered questions. I think he answered honestly that he could not tell you that he told Alistair that he was taking testosterone. The chairman pointed out that the notes contained a reference to it, and the doctor at that point indicated that it was possible that some communication had occurred, but he has not told you under oath that he did communicate it. Alistair has sworn to you under oath that he did not know. He also, Alistair, to his credit, when he was in continued pain, contacted the physician before he injected himself. He didn't just take it upon himself to take an injection. He did what a prudent person does, anybody, an athlete, a non-athlete. He calls the physician, he says, this is what's going on, and the decision is made that he can re-inject. Most importantly, if he's doing this for enhancement purposes, why is the vial still got the mixture? He didn't use it all. He preserved it. He produced it. I think it's important that a license with conditions can send a message that's an important message. When you are dealing with a doctor, and I was here earlier and I heard there were people that were dealing with people that weren't medically suited for assistance. But when you're dealing with a physician who has credentials, who deals with other athletes, who Alistair met in the context of a sanctioned fight where the doctor was representing the governmental authority that was putting on the fight, was Alistair to question what he was getting? Now, if Alistair was taking something for enhancement purposes, then it falls completely on his shoulders. He shouldn't get his license, but that's not the facts of this situation. He took an aqueous solution of testosterone without knowledge that he was taking it for purposes of healing an injury that he had sustained entertaining tens of thousands of people. We can't lose sight of that either. This isn't him taking something so he can do better. It's taking something because he suffered as a result of everybody's basic enjoyment of the sport. Yeah, he's the kind. Nobody's in better shape. Nobody works harder. His performance at the fight against Brock made that clear. I mean, I was mad I bought a ticket. It happened so fast. I'm asking you, when you have somebody who comes forward as honestly and conscientiously as he did, I've been in a lot of courtrooms. I've seen a lot of witnesses. Composure of a witness tells you something about that witness. If the witness is as composed and as natural in his responses, and remember, English is a second language. I mean, I'm amazed. I've been happy to meet him because he's a special person. He's not just a tremendous fighter. He's got a true intellect. cares about people, he cares about his responsibilities to the sport, and he gave up voluntarily a very big event for himself out of respect to the process and to the institutions that are involved. If you could give him a license with conditions, a condition that he not fight until the end of the summer, August 31st, a condition that he test, if that's something that you need for him to take urine tests every couple of weeks that are provided to the commission, we'd be happy to do that at his expense. But there has to be some consideration for the fact that this gentleman did not knowingly and intentionally ingest something for the purpose of enhancing his performance, which would be contrary to whatever